So when you roll a dice, one can occur, right? One, two,
three, four, five, six.
Four, five, six. This is all outcome, so sample space. But when we talk of event, you want something. For example, you want you are playing a game. You want to roll. You need to roll more than four. So what's your event?
Event equal five.
You need to roll a number. Let's say it's X. So greater than four. You need for that one because so which numbers are there? Five and six. So event a part of the sample space. That's special task.
Teacher, can you just write event equal five, six?
Yes, no problem. Yeah, you can write. It's okay. Just I want to specify what kind of event, but you can write. No problem. This is what you need. Outcomes, event, sample space. Outcomes, results. When you do an experiment, it's result. If you toss a tail, so it can be head or tail. So which one occurs is an outcome. So when you say sample space, all outcomes, everything. Possible things, but we cannot write here seven if you roll a dice. This is first. There is a counting principle. If you do more experiments, so how can you calculate total outcomes? You need to multiply them. For example, if there is a first experiment, let's say experiment one, the number of this one, let's make it four. So if there is another experiment you are doing and the number of this experiment two, let's say five. If you do it together, how many total outcomes it can occur?
Like what, teacher? Experiment, what do you mean by experiment?
So four times five. Experiment means, for example, you roll a dice. Let's roll a dice.
Yes.
Four roll a dice. How many outcomes? Six.
Six.
Let's toss a coin. These are easy things. How many outcomes?
Two.
Two. If you do it together. So. Go. Roll a dice, and toss a coin. How many outcomes possible? So you multiply them, six times two, 12. Okay?
Okay.
If you do two or more experiment, you need to multiply each one by one. So let's clean that one. Any question about that one? I don't think so. You are very silent today. Here, any question? It's on the book. We saw that one, I am sure, but...
It's easy. Yet.
Yeah, this is very easy. All possible outcomes. If there are nine chairs from one to nine, they put numbers. One, oops, sorry. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. This is sample space. So we show it with E, sample space. So... Odd number is an event. She maybe need to sit an odd number. So which number is odd? One, three, five, seven, nine. This is answer of B. So event. This is not all. This is a part of it. Okay?
Okay.
I want to show one more things. Ah, that one. But there is a spinner. As you see, it's number one and two. And tossing a coin. Yeah, we did that one, but let's make a revision a bit first. So you want to toss a coin. One and two. So for spinner, event of spinner, sample space of spinner, what, how many element are there?
One and two, but for like all of them, it's...
Two. What about number of tossing a coin?
Two, like tail and head.
Again, two. Together, if you do it together,
four
times two equal four. So your outcomes, it must be in the total four outcomes you have. So to calculate these outcomes, it will help us to calculate probability.
In the exam, will you like bring a question saying what is the outcome?
Yes, what is the total outcomes? What is the number of outcomes? So number of now, we, if you remember, we show it with N, for example, event, number of event, or number of sample space. We show it N.
Mr. Rola, I didn't understand.
Which part?
This part.
But there are two things.
Nope. Yes.
All possible outcomes. It's all possible outcomes, right? How many outcomes do you, it will in the total we have to write? 2-4 spinner, as you see 1 and 2, and a coin, you know of coin, right? 2-4 coin. In the total, you must write 2 times 2, 4 outcomes. Let's write them. Let's write them. Yeah. Let's write them.
Tail 1, tail 2.
1 and tail, 1 and head. So a spinner can land at the 1 part and coin can be tail. Or spinner can land 2, sorry, and 1, no problem. And coin can be head. So spinner can land 2 and head, 2 and tail. All possible outcomes. How many of them? 1, 2, 3, 4. I must find 4 of them, so it's right.
So if we don't calculate the outcomes, so just we this, just know the answer.
If it's only asking number, multiply the numbers. If it's right, saying write all the possible outcomes, so write.
As a teacher, when I was solving these questions, I didn't do the outcome. I just knew that.
Teacher,
yes.
All time you must write, for example, case in the question.
How T?
Taste.
Where is taste? Huh? Toss. This one?
Yes.
This is a tossing toss coin. Do you know what? Tossing a coin is another thing. So there is a coin, iron money, you throw it. So it's head or tail.
Okay.
So look at that one. Again, there are some things. Cones, waffle cones, cup cones, pistachio, strawberry. We saw that one, right?
Yes.
So it's same idea. You need to write one by one. In the total, let's find the number here. Number of cones, 4 holes, 3. Number of ice cream, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In the total, you need to get 15 different outcomes for that one. How we calculate it is important. You can write like that. Cake cones, vanilla. Cake cones, chocolate. Cake cones, strawberry. Cake cones, pistachio. Cake cones, coffee. So you can write one by one. It will take time, of course. We wrote it in lesson, so I'm not going to write it again. As you see, there is how many outcomes. If the question asking only how many outcomes possible, you need to write outcomes. You need to write a number, not all, every outcome,
teacher,
one by one. Yes.
For the last question, if in the exam, for all possible options, if you just
write.
Do that.
No, you must write all the possible outcomes. You must write all the
possible. But how do we write cake, cone, vanilla? Do we just write them next to each other?
Why you didn't write? In the lesson, I told it.
I did write it.
I check it. Cake, cone, vanilla. Cake, cone, strawberry. And you can use things, so it will be easy. Okay, let's see. A game include a number cube. So number of a number cube, 6 element. So in the total outcome, 6 outcomes for number cube. Spinner divided into 4 equal sectors. So number of outcomes of spinner, double N. What is it? 4. Each player roll the number cube and spin the spinner. How many outcomes are possible? How many outcomes? 2 things. So we need to multiply them. 6 times 4, 24 outcomes. If there are 2 things given, not related things given, we multiply the outcomes and we find total outcomes. So number of cube, number cube and spinner together is equal 24.
But how do you write cube and spinner? Like
I wrote cube and spin. You throw roll the cube, you spin the spinner after that.
Okay.
So that's
how know this the cube is 4.
Spinner is 4. Spinner 4 is written. Number cube, it's a dice. Number two, how many numbers on the dice?
Teacher, 6.
A 6. A 4 is given at the spinner. 4, 6 times 4 together make 24.
This is, so we have to write 24 outcomes.
Yes, 24 outcomes. 24 outcomes.
So like we write 1, 1, 2, like 2, 3.
We don't write it. In that one, how many outcomes are possible? You don't need to write it.
Oh, okay.
If it say write all the possible outcomes, you have to write, but we don't write 24 outcomes. I don't think so. Let's continue with 4-2. I don't want to save that one. I want to continue with 4-2. Probability. If you remember from seventh grade, probability is the chance of something happen, the value of it. In mathematics, we use value. So probability is chance of something happen. We show it with P. P of the probability and the name of the event, as you see. Don't forget that one. It's all time between 0 and 1. And there is no probability of greater than 1, less than 0. Let's continue. Rolling and greater than 5 with a number cube. 5, you need to roll 5. What is the chance? Likely, unlikely, as likely as not?
Likely. Unlikely, actually.
Greater than 5. So, all possible outcomes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. As you see, it's a small chance. 5 and 6. Greater than 5. Only 6. Rolling a 6. What is the unlikely? It's a small chance, right?
Yes.
Next section, we will learn how to calculate it. We will learn how to find the value. Such as what? Event, it's equal 6, right? Only 6. The number of event 1, so probability, a number greater than 5, it will be number of event. How many numbers are there? 1. Over number of sample space, all possible outcomes. How many of them? 6. Number 6. So probability of greater than 5, rolling greater than 5 is 1 over 6.
Then we change that into percentage.
No, I don't think so. Maybe we will ask, maybe we don't. I'm not sure about it. You know how to change fraction to percentage. But...
يعني لانو اگر شوتي greater 5 او تو ابي السرو 5 اكاك يعني 6.
لا خوارا.
No. You are wrong. Karno.
Tisha, if you say greater than 5, you write 6.
Only 6 greater than 5, right?
Yes.
But seven, one element. Next section, I will explain it one detail. At the moment, we are just talking how we find things, events,
okay,
and outcomes. Drawing a blue marble from back of black and white. Even we don't know numbers, in the back
of
the black and white. So what is it? Can you pull a blue?
No, impossible.
So impossible mean as a number is 0. So these are same ideas. What is the probability not drawing a pink? If drawing a pink 1 over 6, not drawing a pink, if you remember, 1 minus 1 over 6, it's equal 5 over 6. You don't need to calculate that way. You don't need to calculate it that way.
Wait, what?
What?
1 minus 1 over 6 is 5 over 6?
Yes.
How?
This is primary school. So instead of 1, I can write 6 over 6 minus 1 over 6. It's equal 5.
Oh, that's... Okay.
So that's it. That's the second section. Let's continue with real probability, how things work. 4-3. This is experimental probability. What does it mean, experimental? We are targeting next step. We are targeting about the next step. We do some things for, we will think about the next step. We will guess some things. We will have some idea about next step. So how we find it? Number of times the events happen or occur. Total number of tried. So you try some things. 10 times. If it's, for example, 10 try, 2 times happened. So what is the probability next time it can happen? 2 over?
10.
Yes, you are right, 10.
And then we simplify.
1 over 5, 2 over 10. So let's see an example. Look, Siobhan made saves. How many saves? 15 save. So probability of next one, look, next shot. It's asking next one. Probability of next, it's save. So it's asking about he will save or not. So 15 out of how many? 25.
So 35.
15 times save, but 25 shoots. That's mean 10 he couldn't. So 15 over 25. How many times happen? In how many times it's trial? How many saves? How many shoot?
And then we simplify.
Yes, sir.
You simplify. What? Yes.
Sir, what are you doing? Yeah, Nikki. Well.
Teacher, for you wrote P and then save. Can we just write P event?
No, event. No, the only write probability equal P equal. You can write P equal. No problem.
Oh, okay.
Karno, what do you mean?
Teacher, I can't by English. Yeah.
Teacher, he say how do you do?
Very easy. I same things. Look, what is the rule?
No, teacher. I know. But do I ever have a job? No.
After 15 over 25, you find probability equal 15 over 25. It say as a fraction. You can simplify that one. You can simplify that one. It will be called 3 over 5. This is fraction.
Then we divide it by 5.
It's a decimal. You can make it 6 over 10. So it's equal 0.6. This is decimal. Then as a percentage, 60%. You can enlarge by 100. So 6 over 100. It's equal 60%.
Teacher, wait 1 minute. This is how I like... is this like always correct? And then by 3, I get the decimal.
Yes, you can get decimals, but this 3 divided by 5. Be careful here. This is 3 divided by 5.
What did I write?
You write 5 divided by 3. But maybe
5 outside, that's what I meant.
Maybe you did the right same things, but be careful about it. This one divided by 5. Maybe you write
so 5 outside, that's what you mean.
So it's work. It's all time works.
Teacher, teacher, go back, please. No.
Maybe space. Yeah, okay.
Teacher, why you are 6/10?
Oh, how I found that one? This is fractional. Last year, maybe previous year, I told it. If I enlarge by 2, 5 times, I will get 10. And how it's 6/100? If I multiply by 10 here, 6/100. Okay?
Anladım.
Clever man, yeah. Okay. Will be above. Be careful here. Will be above 16 degrees. So how many of them above the 16 degrees? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Is that right?
Yes.
So 15 over 21 above the probability of temperature above the 15. Sorry, let's clean it up. Sorry, let's clean that part. Probability of temperature is greater than 16. It's equal how many of them? 15. How many day we have in the total in 3 weeks? 21. This is temperature is greater than 16. What about not greater than 16? There are two ways to solve it. You can subtract this one from the 1 minus 15 over 21, or you can count from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 over probability of not greater than 16 equal. Sorry, there's a video. How many of them? 6 over 21. Any question?
So then we don't do anything else.
No, you don't need to do anything else.
Okay.
That's it. Other questions are same idea. For example, for next one, it say 14 times and 20 tries, right? 14 out of 20. So probability of next 14 over 20, 7 over 10. Same idea. So I'm not continuing with that one. Let's continue with 4 theoretical probability. So in the theoretical probability, we don't try anything. Just we think it can happen or not. Like number of event over number of sample space. So you can think about this one event. So what you check for, and this is sample space, number of sample space.
This is for exam, midterm exam. Just chapter 4.
No, 5-1, 5-2.
Teacher,
like
the last chapter.
Okay, let's see an example. Look, find the probability drawing one of the 12 E. You want to draw one thing, but there are 12 of them. How many tiles? 100 Scrabble tiles. So what do you think about it? Probability of pulling E. It's equal. How many?
12 over 100.
We have how many Scrabble tiles? 100.
Isn't this like the last?
Yes, it looks like same, but the idea is different. This is not for the next job. This is only you want to pull randomly things. You didn't do anything. You didn't do any experiment. There is no saving things. There is no shooting. There is no voiding. There is nothing.
But we solve the same way.
Idea is same. Idea. Event overall. Event overall.
Oh, okay.
Number of event over number of sample space. That's more good. Okay.
Teacher, can you go back? No, the previous.
Of course, this is not finished here. As a fraction, you can simplify by 4, 3 over 25. As a decimal, 0.12. And as percentage, 12%, because it's a fraction, decimal, and percent. Do not forget, this is a revision lesson, so I hope it makes some things clear for you. Okay, let's continue. Find the probability of rolling a number cube greater than 6. We already know sample space. How many elements on the sample space for number cube? 6. How many numbers greater than 2?
4.
Greater than 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4 numbers. So what is the probability? Probability of greater than 2, it's mean 4 elements and all of them 6, 4 over 6.
What can you say again?
Of course, from the beginning, slowly, but this time. Read the question. Reading question is very important. So, question telling us, you will roll a number cube. There is no cheating on it. It's a fair, probably. Yes, fair number cube. So you want to get more than two. Think about, you are playing a game.
Three.
If you roll more than two, you will win. So you want to roll more than two. What is the chance of more than two? So which number is more than two? 3, 4, 5, 6. This means 4 element. Over. Yes. How many numbers on the number cube? 6.
6.
Over 6. So probability is equal 4 over 6.
So the why you didn't write 3?
4 over 6. If you simplify it, 2 over 3.
Teacher, number Q, what is this? Why I didn't understand number Q? Ah, Allah.
I will show, number Q. Did you see?
Aha, teacher, this is Chajmari, yeah.
Let's say dice. It's actually meaning dice. Dice. These are, okay?
Teacher, hatta 6 is.
Yeah, but in the number cube, we have in the total 6, but more than 2. So if I looking for an event more than 2, so what we have more than 2? 3, 4, 5, 6. If you roll one of them, you will win. How many number here? 1, 2, 3, 4 number. Four number you must roll. But in the total, we have 6 number, right?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Let's continue the next page. I think the same.
Go back. I want to write.
We wrote all of them, Mr. Sinin. We wrote all of them. These are old lessons. I don't have time to make you write. I will put this video on YouTube. You can check from the YouTube.
Basta ca record ya.
Okay, teacher, go.
Okay, thank you very much. Find the correct probability. Throwing a boy's name. Let's read the question. There are 11 boys, 16 girls. My question is that one. How many students in the class? Total number of students. How many students in the class?
20.
11 plus 16. What is 11 plus 16? 27. But it's asking probability of boy. How many boy?
11.
11 boys. Over how many students in the total?
27.
What about girls?
Girls.
16 girls. All of them.
27.
Don't forget, what is want? Number of what we want. Numerator, number of all possible things, everything's denominator.
Thank you.
Yes, let's continue.
We
don't need to solve more examples. You can solve on your own. That much is enough. Let's continue another section because we have 8 minutes.
No. Central tendency, please.
Lesson after the break because I'm on duty.
Okay, tell me in Viber, okay?
No, I will add Mercury after 10 or 15 minutes.
Okay, yeah, but tell us.
Choosing a graph, you need to understand that one. Bar graph, you need to compare things. If you remember, line graph, there must be change during the time. This is the simple keyword, compare. Change and time. There must be change and time. Venn diagram, there must be relation between two or more data sets. So there must be grouping.
Teacher, you said Venn and circle won't come.
Grouping. Maybe it's Sula, how can I know? But usually we ask this too. I say that, but usually this is more clear. Circle graph. Look, there must be one set. Look, a set. That means one set, we divide it into parts. One group, there is a one group, one idea, but we divide it into parts. Okay? If you divide into parts, we use circle graph. If you know that much, let's solve one question. The price of 6 television. What will you do with
bar graph?
Television? Bar graph. Because you want to compare them. What about the height of person from birth to age 21? So it will increase during the time. That means there's a change during the time. Line graph. Okay?
Teacher, what is this? The prices of 6 television. You write bar graph.
Think about that. You want to buy television. There are 6 different television. What will you do the price? You will compare them. Which one is cheap? Which one is expensive? Right? Yes. So you want to compare them. If we compare them, we will use bar graph. That kind of graph. Can you see your bar graph?
Yes.
Let's continue. Let's
number 2.
Yes, teacher, please go. Just explain central tendency.
4-6.
Yeah.
4-6 is not. 4-6 organizing data. I don't need to explain unit count, for example. This must be 0, sorry. Let's like that one. This is 0 from 150, not 56, because 51 is here. So you need to count one by one and write here the numbers. If say 5, the first cumulative will start 5. Let's say this is 12, this must be 17, 5 plus 12. Let's say this is 3, 17 plus 3 is 20. Let's say this is 9, 20 plus 9, 29. But you need to count it from here. You need to count how many of them between 151 and 150. If you remember writing that one, this is easy, huh?
Yeah, it was really
easy. Well, I don't know.
I'm not going to tell that one, really.
Akhirde teacher, what are you doing there?
You need to count how many numbers is between 141 and 150. Count it.
Teacher.
2, 3, 4, 5. So write.
No. Teacher, there. Just one minute.
So write here 5. So count between 160. Count it and write it here. Oh, 6. Sorry, you are right. Thank you, Karno. 6. Okay. You need to count it. That's all. How we graph it? How we graph it? This is important. How we graph it? It's a bit important. Let's say the first one here, 141 to 150. What is the number of it? 7. Let's say 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Where is the 7? It's here. 7. And 151, 160. What is the number? 16. 15 is here, 16 a bit above it. So how we draw it? Histogram that way, okay?
Okay.
I told in the lesson, so you already know from previous years probably. So
No, this one is easy.
Okay. We still have 4 minutes to go.
And my battery is low.
4-7. Let's come to central tendency. That's an important task. If this is
how do you find it?
If this finished, let's directly start it again.
Okay.
What was I doing? Oh, central tendency. You already know from previous year how you calculate mean, median. I will give them again, but what is the central tendency? Central tendency, if there are numbers, central tendency show where is the numbers grouping together. Such as what? Let's put some point on the number line. Let's say this is a number line. Let's say 5, 0, 10. Let's put some numbers on that one. Here a number, here another number, here a number, here another one. There are lots of numbers. Here a number, here a number. There are lots of numbers around the 5. Here another number, here another number. So where are the numbers grouping? Here, right? Around the 5. So central tendency shows where are the numbers? We have lots of numbers. Which around what? Around 5 we have lots of numbers, right?
But how do we know if it's mean, median, or mode?
Yes, how do we know it? That's a good question, actually. That must be some place here. Okay. Do you remember what was outlier?
Yeah, of course.
There's
an outlier
from the group. If there is no outlier, and we can use mean. If there is an outlier, we will use median. If there is a number, repeat lots of times, such as what? 5, 5, 7, 5, 5, 5, 2, 5, 5. Can you see there are lots of 5? So we will use mod. But this means lots of 5. Okay?
So if there's an outlier, we use median. If there's no
outlier, we use mean.
Mod or mean?
Mean. Mod, only there are lots of repeating numbers. Okay?
What if there's like...
repeating number? No. We will
teacher.
Use mean
teacher.
Or... Yes.
Teacher.
No, teacher. I'm saying if there's an outlier and repeating numbers.
Shall I?
If there are lots of repeating number, mod, but... If there is an outlier, but it's only 2-3 value repeating, not lots of, so median.
Hello.
Oh, okay. What time we use mean?
If there is no outlier, no lots of repeating number, we will use mean.
Oh. Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome. If you